Hello students, today we discuss about the continuation of next subtopic in molecular basis of inheritance, that is 6.7 translation. Normally where translation takes place in cytoplasm. So what are the machinery required for this translation and all? The machinery required for translation, that is ribosomes. As well as tRNA, mRNA, amino acids. These are, apart from this one, amino acid synthetase, tRNA synthetase, an NGM. So these are the minimum requirements of for translation process and all. Then ribosomes. In this ribosomes, suppose if it is a prokaryotic one, 70S ribosomes. If it is eukaryotic one, 80S one. What are the subunits of 70S? 50 as well as 30S. Whereas 80S, 60 as well as 40S subunits and all. Then, why? Because inside the ribosomes only the translation process takes place and all. In this one, how subunits of ribosomes, it must associate it with the help of magnesium ion. Subunits association with the help of magnesium ion. After completion of translation means here the protein, that polypeptide chain, it must be formed under. After completion of this one, immediately it must be dissociated. Then for association purpose, the magnesium ion acts as a vital role for association the two subunits of ribosomes and all. Then here in these ribosomes, here it will be present, three important sites are present. That is EPA and all. That important set, there is an exit one, E for exit set, P for peptide or donor, exit or peptide, another one P, A for acceptor or amino acid acceptor 1. So these three important major the sites are present inside the ribosomes and all. Then wherever actively participate the ribosome, that means active involvement of peptides and all, active protein. Why? Because ribosomes, otherwise regarded as protein factory, that protein synthesis of the ribosomes, we called as polysomes and all. In this active protein synthesis, why? Because it is a protein factory, ribosomes are related to protein factory, this is a protein synthesis, that is we called as polysome and all. So how much angstroms present in polysome? That is 360 degrees, that is 360 angstroms. The polysome or that ribopolysome are 36 nanometer towards the direction, towards that particular place, it is present in this polysome cell. So that much important role for these ribosomes and all. especially in that peptidyl site is present both two units in between the side of both two units and all. Whereas exit as well as acceptor, it is present first larger subunit only. Then related to tRNA, in the tRNA it carries that specific amino acids and all. Whenever carrying the specific amino acid, but how it will be attached that particular specific amino acid with the help of aminoacyl synthetase enzyme, it helps to bind one tRNA, it binds one specific amino acid towards the 3' end. So tRNA on 3' end, that is a CCA, that particular region amino acid attachment site only. Then in that one, already you know which part of tRNA it binds to the ribosomes. Ribosomal binding area, that is a TCC, that particular arm and arm. Then related to one more area in the DHU, that is it attaches that related to amino acyl synthetase enzyme and all. Then different types of tRNAs, different types of that particular amino acids, it must be binding and all. Then related to mRNA, here mRNA, here coded amino acid information is present and all. It is also, it read 5' to 3' only, but it bind to the ribosomes with the help of 5' end, that is a cap one, because of guanosine, that is a methyl guanosine triphosphate is present, that it must be attached and all. In this one, reuse, once one can completion of the polypeptide chain, once again reuse, that's why in one particular cell, multiple number of proteins are formed with the help of reuse after completion of this protein synthesis or polypeptide chain formation. Another very important one, no one mRNA does not recognize that specific amino acid. Then who will recognize this particular amino acid? Yes, that is related to tRNA, that is adapter RNA. So it does not recognize the amino acids. Then with the help of adapter RNA, that means tRNA, the specific amino acids, that specific triplet codon are present towards the mRNA, but it does not recognize. Who will recognize? With the help of anticodon, that means adapter tRNA, it must recognize and bind and formation of peptide chain, that is related to mRNA. It must be reusable and all. Then amino acids, how many number of amino acids are present, where it present amino acids are present, cytoplasmic pool or cellular pool, it located cellular pool. These are building blocks of proteins or monomers. This is total number 20 different types of amino acids present, variously it arranged, then forms into the different types of proteins and all. So very multiple number of proteins are formed within one particular cell only by continuously rearrangement while formation inside this the translation process and all. Then amino acyl tRNA synthetase, it is already present in a DHU loop area in the tRNA. It helps to bind a specific amino acid in 3' end of tRNA. Without this enzyme, there is no binding of that specific amino acid towards that specific area of tRNA and all. Then what is the mechanism? These are machinery of tRNA. What is the mechanism of translation? Then what is the mechanism? The first and important one, activation of amino acid. how amino acids already present cytoplasmic pool, how it must be activated while formation of that particular polypeptide chain and all. Here the amino acid combined with adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP, at the presence of magnesium, then it must activate it. That is amino acid. This amino acid, by combination of ATP molecule as well as enzyme amino acyl tRNA synthetase under. Here enzyme, remember carefully, amino acyl tRNA synthetase at the presence of magnesium ionic form, then it activate amino acid AMP, then plus inorganic pyrophosphate. This is inorganic pyrophosphate. This total we represent, we call as amino acyl adenylate enzyme complex and all. Amino acyl adenylate enzyme complex. It is formed. It must required for further formation of that specific this translation process and all. This is the first step and all. Then after formation of this enzyme particular complex and all, then related to charging or amino acylation, or simply we called as amino acylation. In this charging, what must be charged here? Normally tRNA it must chargeable. How it must be charged? With the help of amino acyl adenylate enzyme complex, it must charge. Here related to all these amino acid, then enzyme complex plus tRNA. With the help of that particular 3' end, it must bind. Then only it must be chargeable. Then it forms as this one. Amino acid tRNA plus, here the removal of AMP adenosine monophosphate as well as that particular enzyme amino acid synthetase enzyme, then it must be bind amino acid to bind with tRNA. It must be formed here with the help of this. Then after formation this one, then initiation that related to initiation. In this specific initiation, that the specific initiation factors are required. What are the specific initiation factors it must be required under? If it is a prokaryotic, 3 initiation factors are required under. Initiation factor 1, initiation factor 2, initiation factor 3. This particular one, if it is prokaryotic. If it is eukaryotic, there are 9 initiation factors are present. That is eukaryotic initiation factor 1. Like this one. Four A, B, C, D. In that 4, there are 4 subdivisions are present. Then eukaryotic initiation factor 5, initiation factor 6. Like that 9, that initiation factors are present in eukaryotic and all. It is present, maximum initiation factors are present. It helps for initiation, for beginning the formation of that protein, that formation of polypeptide chain and all. In this work, the first, the 40S, 40S subdivision, suppose if it is a eukaryotic organism plus mRNA with the help of initiation factor 2, it required, then it combine 40S, then it associate with the mRNA. Normally, one among these one, the smaller subunit of ribosomes and all. Then, apart from this one, their continuation, the 40S, one among these smaller subunit, as well as mRNA, then it combining with the tRNA, which are initiation codon. Already I said, what is initiation codon? That is a methionine. Whenever combined with the methionine, then with the help of eukaryotic initiation, that factor 3, along with the guanosine triphosphate, along with the GTP molecule, then it forms then 40S, mRNA, then tRNA, that is the methionine. Like that, it combine and all. Then apart from this one, one more larger subunit is there. Then continuation, then same 40S, mRNA, the tRNA methionine plus 60S. With the help of initiation factor 1 or initiation factor 4. That initiation factor 1 or initiation factor 4. This any one among the subdivision. This one, it helpful for formation of both are combined. 40 plus 60, these two subunits, it will associate to form into the ATS and all. Like that. ATS, then apart from this one, mRNA and tRNA methionine. Like this initiation, first one can start it. Once it begins, then automatically with the help of that specific enzymatic associated that particular enzymes, then polypeptide chain continuously takes place and all. That in this initiation, after initiation, elongation, the next fourth step, it takes place that elongation. In this elongation, translocation, normally mRNA molecule, that means ribosomal subunits only, it must move from one area to another area. That is translocation with the help of that specific enzyme, specific factors, that is related to elongation factors, especially elongation factor G act as vital role for translocation in prokaryotic cell. Related to eukaryotic one, elongation factor 1 only act as important role. Here, elongation factor 1, that is eukaryotic one, only one it must be present along with the GTP molecule plus GTP. Then whereas for translocation, elongation factor related to apart from that specific guanosine triphosphate G related one, it acts as vital role and all. Then in prokaryotic organism, elongation factor TU as well as elongation factor or TS. Elongation factor TU or elongation factor S related to prokaryotic organisms. Here, TU means that is thermo unstable. Here, elongation factor stable one. That is thermostable one. Here, thermo unstable one. Related to prokaryotic, related to eukaryotic one. With the help of this one, because of that particular polypeptide or polypeptide transferase, enzyme act as a vital role to transmit that P site to the E site or A site to the P site while joining, while combining of these particular amino acids and all. In this one, translocation while moving of subunits of ribosomes, translocate, that means first E site, then P site, then A site, then again translocated, P, A, E, like that, translocated from one site to another site. For this, elongation factor G also act as a crucial role for translocation of these particular in prokaryotic organisms like Escherichia coli and all. In this translocation in related to other organisms with the help of related to caprons act as a vital role for translocation. With the help of this one, translocation, apart from this one, formation of helix peptide chain, that the caprons act as a crucial role, formation of helix chain, that is helix chain of polypeptide. With the help of this one, it act as crucial role and all. So like this, the elongation process takes place. In this elongation, then termination process, then it involves termination. In this termination, releasing factors, another act as a crucial role and all. In this one, that releasing factor, here also releasing factor 1 for eukaryotic, whereas prokaryotic releasing factor 1 as well as 2. Releasing factor, it must recognize a specific that a stop codons which are present on mRNA, then it must stop formation of peptide chain and all. Releasing factor like UAA, UAG, UGA, that this particular one it must recognize. Some of these lower grade like yeast, this one releasing factor 3, it is also it's present to recognize these particular aspects and all. E releasing factor, that is E releasing factor 3, like yeast, that is eukaryotic releasing factor 3. So normally this releasing factor 2 act as important role for dissociation. After completion, it terminate, it separate, again reutilize, reformation, reutilization that particular mRNA and all. In this termination process after dissociation, here dissociation factor act as crucial role, apart from that releasing factor. Whenever and releasing factor, whenever it is present nonsense and stop codons on that mRNA, then automatically ready to stop that particular synthesis, that particular process of polypeptide chain in translation, both eukaryotic as well as prokaryotic organisms and all. In this one, if we observe very simply related to the first one, suppose any one amino acid, this amino acid, it combined with ATP as well as aminoacyl tRNA synthetase enzyme with the help of magnesium, then it forms into the here it combined with like this, it is that amino acyl adenylate, that particular enzyme complex are present, complex are formed. In that 3' prime end, if it is combined with the, this is amino acid, that amide group, in this one already attached with AMP, then plus tRNA, it combined with the tRNA. tRNA normally in this, the 3' prime end of OH, it combined and all. Then, it, after combination of this one, along with enzymatic reactions, then here it combined, like OA, this acceptor site and all. In this acceptor site, like this, it must be formed, the charging of tRNA, the charging of, it is represented diagrammatically, charging of tRNA and all. So like this formed, in this elongation or initiation one, if we observe in the elongation as well as initiation, suppose in initiation if you are observing, this is mRNA, that is 5' prime as well as 3' prime. It is present normally, the small subunit are present attached to the mRNA, the larger subunit it is present. Suppose this is the 40S, this is the 60S, larger subunit and all. Here, anyone that is the initiated codon like AUG, then oppositely it is present like U, like AC. It is combined with, it is present in anticodon site of tRNA. This is tRNA associated. So, once again, remember carefully, last class also I said, if it is matching towards that particular mRNA, then only it bind. If it is not matching, it won't be binded. So, normally amino acid related is present on mRNA site only. It is present on in mRNA only. This is the initiator methionine. It bind then the specific amino acid. This is the specific amino acid, whatever it may be, here suppose methionine, like that, a specific amino acid is present and all. This particular site we called as P site and all, that is the peptidyl site and all. Then, the next site is the acceptor site. Any another one, another any, that is U or related to GUA, then related to CAU, that specific tRNA, this is one protein, between these protein it combined, that is related to peptidyl transferase enzyme. It bind between the two amino acids which are present inside the ribosomes and all. That is, transferase enzyme it bind. Then, in the next stage, it must be moving and all. This is A site and all, acceptor site and all. Then, related to next one, if you are observing, so, it enters that is AUG. This tRNA enters into the E site, then one more it enters. This is this particular GUA here are related to one more site. All are triple U, GUU that related to CAU. That is AAA, which are by in a tRNA already it is there, one group, one more it is again combined with the transferase, that one it must be bind like that. One more ready to enter any a specific anticodons in the tRNA ready to attach to the amino acid or acceptor site of that particular ribosomal subunits, it ready to attach and all. Like this, in forthcoming whatever it is present, again it will be binding under here also. Anyone in the tRNA, anyone one can write like C, A, G or G, A, C, like this. Oppositely, that anticodons like this, it must be formed and all. At the time of termination, at the time of this one, it must be completely removed and all. Like this helical structurally, it must be removed. Like peptide, it separate from that ribosomes and all. When it separate, whenever in the termination, that means that specific factor, whenever that specific factor are present, that is a releasing factor, then suppose U, G, A it is present under tRNA, then suppose U, A, A, like this nonsense codon it is present here already. All get together it is present, whenever this one, then it is ready to separate one. This is lower, this is upper one. Both are separated. Larger subunit and smaller subunit, this is mRNA and releasing factor. Both are separated with the help of dissociated factor. With the help of dissociated, first one can associate with the help of magnesium, what I said. Like this, one another, this bond, peptide bond, with the help of peptide, or this particular, suppose if it is prokaryotic ribosome, or peptide, NGM, with the help of that particular NGM, it must be attached one another, a group of proteins, a group of amino acids form into the peptides. Then, after separate, once again, ready to, it must be formed in one more chain, one more formation, that's why several hundreds of proteins present within one particular cell due to repeatedly reusing of that particular, this particular protein synthesis or formation of this specific type of the peptides and all in the translation process. So you must remember, translation means whatever coded amino acids present on mRNA with the help of tRNA, then the specific amino acids are attached in that to tRNA, both it recognized on that mRNA one up to tailing end under, until nonsense one it is moving under with the help of a translocation with the help of guanosine triphosphate and all these particular aspects until nonsense codon. It must be moving. Then it must be formed peptide with the help of transferase or a peptidyl transferase enzyme, both the P site to the A site, then exit site, then vice versa, exit site normally present into the larger one, again ready to attach one more amino acid and all, the specific one. For that specific amino acid, it requires amino acid synthetase enzyme and all. So this is one specific, one particular orderly takes place. For this, in exam point of view, remember what are the machinery, what are the tools required for translation related to different types of the factors it required. So where it required releasing factor, where it required initiation factor, releasing factor required for termination, initiation factor required for initiation, which it begins the formation of peptide and all. Okay, that is once or twice you must read carefully.